Hello everybody, welcome to Developing Success, and today we are going to complete the topic of current affair and also the government scheme which is in relation to the health sector, that is Ayushman Bharat. And recently the COVID-19 outbreak, the pandemic coronavirus which is going on, recently Ayushman Bharat was also attached to COVID-19 issue. So the Ayushman Bharat is also known as the Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. So let me first tell you the system of healthcare in India, which is divided in three categories. The first one is the primary, the second one is the secondary, and the third one is the tertiary category. So if we talk about the primary healthcare system, it is the first point of the care, like the minor health issues, where we go to the general physicians. So like, for example, just a normal flu or a normal cold, fever, some headaches, these things can be diagnosed and can be cured in a local area in a primary healthcare system. That is the primary thing. Next to the secondary thing, where some advanced diagnostic therapies and measures are taken in the clinics and the hospitals. So here comes the hospitals in the scenario where we can call it the secondary system. But if these hospitals are super specialty hospitals and are related to some particular disease, then we call it the tertiary healthcare system. So Ayushman Bharat has tried to cover all the three components of the primary, secondary, and the tertiary healthcare system in India. So now we study about the Ayushman Bharat Yojana. It was actually launched in 2017 because it was recommended by the National Health Policy in 2017. Let me tell you that health is a state subject. So it is very unusual for the central government to launch a very big scheme like the Ayushman Bharat by the central government, okay? Because the health is a state subject, the implementation, the financing is a major hazard, is a major problem between the center and the state. But because of the cooperative federalism, because of the, you know, state center good relations, this scheme can be implemented in a good way. So National Health Policy 2017 recommended it, that is why the central government launched it. And the vision for this scheme is the universal health coverage, okay? So universal health coverage is their vision. Now, what are the features of the scheme? So previously we have seen in 2008, there was a scheme which was launched by the government of India, Rashtriya Swasth Bima Yojana. So this was also an insurance scheme, health sector scheme. But here, what was the problem was that in the Rashtriya Swasth Bima Yojana, the maximum size of the family which will be the beneficiary was 5 in number. But if we compare it with the Ayushman Bharat, there is no restriction in the family size or age. Now, the Rashtriya Swasth Bima Yojana was not cashless, okay? It was an insurance scheme. So, but this Jan Arogya Yojana or the Ayushman Bharat Yojana, here you can just straight away walk to the hospitals, take the treatment and come back. It is a cashless scheme, okay? All the money which are to be provided to the hospitals, like the private hospitals or the public hospitals, it will be provided by the government of India and the government of the state. So it is a need-based healthcare service. Need-based is whenever that problem arises, you can just go. So the prevention, the promotion, and the ambulatory care, these are the three principles of this scheme. And it is totally sponsored by the government, both by the central government and the state government collectively. It is implemented by the National Health Agency. This health agency was also renamed as National Health Agency recently in 2019. And this has become a implementing agency for the Ayushman Bharat scheme. As I told you, cashless hospitalization is the biggest feature, is the biggest, USP of this scheme. So no restriction on the family size, which actually was 5 in the Rashtriya Swasth Bima Yojana. And let me tell you, this Rashtriya Swasth Bima Yojana is subsumed in this scheme Ayushman Bharat, okay? So, and there is no restrictions on basis of gender or age also. and public hospitals will be reimbursed at par with the private hospitals. So here comes one criticism. This criticism was recently made by Indian Medical Council, and this Indian Medical Council told that public hospitals will be paid by the government at par of the private hospitals. If those hospitals belong to the government only, why the government should pay to those hospitals? Okay, so this is a big question which was put up recently, and in the way of critical analysis, you can also use the same point while you write your mains examination answer. Next point of the feature is it includes cost for diagnostic services, drugs like the medicines, room charges in hospitals, physician fees, surgeon charges, supplies, ICU and OT charges. So all the charges are included. Now it is subsumed, it has subsumed the 2008 launched Rashtra Swasthya Bima Yojana, as I told you. And who will be the beneficiaries of this scheme? So the beneficiaries will be actually identified according to the socio-economic and caste census, which was done in 2011, both for the rural and the urban areas. So now we know what is the need of this scheme. See, in our country, as projected by the World Bank, as the World Bank says, that we are a lower middle income country. So if we are a lower middle income country, so the parity, the income parity and the process of the whole economy does not have equality. See, the poorest categories and the richest categories both stays in India. So the data which has been seen is, over the last two decades, the government of India's overall expenditure on health has remained stagnant, and which is about 1.2% of the total GDP. See, the source I have taken is from the National Health Accounts 2015. So the source is authentic, that in the last two decades, that is in 20 years, only 1.2% of the total GDP has been spent on the health sector. So thus, it has been deduced that increasing healthcare needs coupled with high out-of-pocket expenditure is a leading cause of poverty in India. We all know how much expensive are the health sectors in India, the hospitals in India, especially the private ones, and some special kind of treatment is needed for particular diseases like cancer, like cirrhosis and all. And a large amount of money is, you know, wasted actually by the people in this sector, and which makes them poor. So the poverty rate increases if the health sector is not funded by the government of India. Not only does it keep the people poor, but it also pushes nearly 6 crore Indians back into poverty each year. So the people who are somewhat well-being and above the poverty line, and they're doing well in life, but unfortunately, if some disease arrived in their family, so that will make them poor because of the large amount of treatment cost in India. So 6 crore Indians are pushed back to poverty. Now the 2011-12 data says that more than 55 million Indians were pushed into poverty because of rising expenditure on healthcare. See, all this data you should use, you should quote them in your essay paper, you should use them in your paper 2, paper 3, that will be very useful. And at the national level, India has 0.62 doctors for every 1,000 population, as opposed to the World Health Organization standard of 1 doctor per 1,000 population. But this is not the condition every year. So somewhere the condition also prevails, like for example in Tamil Nadu, for example in Kerala, and also in states like Delhi, we have a good number of doctors which when compared to other countries, we stand in par with the Sweden, Norway, Denmark's standards. Okay, so somewhere we have 326 doctors per 1,000 population. But this is again causing imparity. This is all again causing inequality, because then these states become the health tourism sectors, which create a havoc in the urban sector also. So there should be equal distribution of the hospitals, because it again the patient, the consumer, again has to bear a cost of transport to reach these states, and again the same poverty vicious circle comes in the way. So that is why the Ayushman Bharat was launched. So it has two components. The first is the health and wellness center, and the second is the Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. So we study about the first one, the health and wellness center. So the health and wellness center actually will see the primary health sector in India, and what is the principle is the disease prevention and health promotion. This health and wellness center and the primary healthcare sector of India is also attached to the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan component. I have discussed that in the Swachh Bharat lecture. I have given the link in the description box, you can see that. So from disease prevention and health promotion, what are they trying to achieve? They're trying to curb the increasing epidemic of non-communicable diseases. Okay, so what will they do? They will upgrade the existing network of sub-centers and primary health centers into health and wellness centers with more know-how and medical facilities, so that the whole process gets into way. So nearly 150,000 health and wellness centers are to be set up in the country over the next few years, which will work towards reducing the overall disease burden and hospitalization needs of the population. So the hospitalization need, the secondary sector comes in picture when the primary health is actually not working and the people are getting more ill day by day. So if we work in the primary health care center, the secondary sector and the tertiary sector will not see too much of burden. Next component is the Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. So this is the demand-led healthcare, and the hospitalization needs are actually seen by this sector, this component. It is the largest health insurance scheme that offers a health cover to nearly 10 crore poor families, which is about 50 crore Indians, that form the 40% of the bottom population of India. And what is the actually scheme? So there is a coverage of up to 5 lakh rupees. See, listen carefully. 5 lakh rupees is not for per person. It is for per family. So if you have 10 members in a family, then also you get 5 lakh rupees. Okay, 5 lakh coverage. If you have 5 members in a family, then also you are getting 5 lakh. So this actually creates a critical thing again. This is a criticism of the scheme again, because if they will be covering per family per annum with 5 lakh rupees, and there is no restriction of the age in the family. So some families are, you know, having 20 people, 15 people, and only 5 lakh rupees are not enough for those families. So according to the size of the family, this amount should have been fixed, which is a kind of loophole in this scheme. So 5 lakh rupees per family per year is given for secondary and tertiary hospitalization. So this is the scheme. Now what all is included? Many things, consultation like diagnosis, pre-hospitalization, and after the hospitalization, the care, the medicine, accommodation, everything, you know, everything is added. And now the COVID-19 coronavirus treatment is also added into the Ayushman Bharat component. And the Ayushman Bharat also covers up to 3 days of pre-hospitalization expenses, such as medicines and diagnostics, covers up to 15 days of post-hospitalization expenses, which include medicines and diagnostics also. So this was all about the Ayushman Bharat scheme. We will sum up the lecture. So this Ayushman Bharat scheme was actually launched in 2017. It is a flagship program of the central government, but the health, again I remind you, is a state subject. So a proper, you know, cooperation will be needed to implement this scheme with the states, and the central government will have to totally cooperate with the state government to implement this scheme into the larger arena. Now, this Ayushman Bharat scheme has two components. The first one is the health and wellness centers, and the next is Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. So, from the health and wellness centers, we are actually looking at the primary healthcare centers. So the already primary healthcare centers and the sub centers, they will be upgraded and new will be also built. So, total number is around 1.5 lakh, that is 1,50,000. And next is your Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana, which is the insurance scheme. So, insurance or assurance, whatever you call. But it is a cashless kind of treatment. Hospitalization in the secondary and the tertiary sector, 5 lakh rupees per family per annum. So, this is the thing, and the empaneled hospitals in the private and the public sector, they can be used for the same. And I also talked about some criticism and hope loopholes in the scheme. You can go through, this will help you both for your prelims and mains examination. Thank you so much. Take care.